Hi, welcome back to the Shtick. We were in the studio of Usher Bilu. Now we've gone into the drawing room. This is actually the study come drawing room where Usher's done some drawings above our head. Which these are copies of Vincent van Gogh.
That's right.
Paintings that you painted yourself.
That's right.
Which are perfect imitations.
Yeah.
And they're brilliant because they were used in the film by Paul Cox called Vincent.
It was the life and death of Vincent van Gogh.
Yes.
And so we worked on this film together. We started together, and then I realized that we need paintings. We need to portray the textures and also the color of the painting as they were at the time, not as they are now.
Mm-hmm.
Which is a complete different picture, you know, because the colors have faded. But I wanted to portray especially this triptych of this two sunflowers and Labrecus in the middle, because he wanted these paintings to hang together. I read it in his letters, of course, and
of course.
So I wanted to make sure that this is going to be in the movie. That's why I painted them like that. And the intriguing aspect of this painting of Labrecus here in the middle is he painted there five times.
Wow.
And we've seen all five of them in different parts of the world. And the most wonderful aspect of this picture is the story behind it, because what he said that he wanted to paint her like a sailor that goes to sea and he leaves his loved one ashore and he can't paint, so he paints her, you know, from memory, but he can't paint. So the picture is he invented a kind of scenario where he paints a naive picture of someone who loves but can't paint very well.
Yes.
And so a sophisticated man that he was invented a kind of scenario where he paints like somebody who can't paint very well but is full of love. But there is a kind of like Rousseau, there is something so wonderful about naive paintings. It's a whole school of painting. And so he invented this kind of
genre.
It's not so much genre. He just set himself a task to paint like somebody who doesn't know quite how to paint, but is full of love. And I just thought that was just
that
a must, you know, to portray in this picture, you know. So that's, well, I gave it a bash and that's the result.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
You also worked with Paul Cox on several other films, including Man of Flowers and Cactus.
Yeah.
And,
well, Man of Flowers was the beginning. It was filmed in this house.
Filmed here, yes.
That's right. And in this room and all over the house and the garden and the church across the road. So that was the beginning of our collaboration, you know. And so, yeah.
You also work with galleries. I remember you having a gallery with your wife, the Luba Bilu Gallery in Greville Street.
That was Luba's gallery.
Yes.
And she was.
But you had some exhibitions there. I remember
I certainly had
a wonderful exhibition where. You remember all that? What was that called?
Of course, Escape. You know,
Escape.
That was for the Melbourne Festival.
Yes.
16 tons of paper,
the shredded paper.
And well, it was a wonderful gallery, and 10 years of great exhibitions. You know, that was a wonderful gallery.
And also, but you had United Artists, which you were involved with before
That's how Luba got involved in the process
of curating.
No, well,
managing. Well, she was managing artists.
She took over, you know, because the artists not very good, you know, as far as running galleries and business wise, and
no, usually not.
Better off in the studio and all of that. So we tried, and we had rosters and so forth, but then we realized that Luba took over after that. And then it became her gallery, really.
Mm.
From
and that was the Tolanos in Fitzroy Street.
Yeah,
it was old George.
He George left, and Massoni
took it over.
Took over, and he gave us a room.
We didn't mention that you make sculptures out of found pieces and things like
yes,
that.
Yes, yeah. I love that aspect of things. I mean, I think the beauty about what you can do these days is so broad that anything goes, and so found objects and work like that has been done for many, many years, but I think today it's accepted. You know, there's so much freedom of expression, and it's absolutely wonderful. But the garden is
spectacular.
A part of my studio.
Yeah,
I've done so much work in the garden. So
and you've got a veggie garden as well, not to mention the veggie garden. This year has been a year of growth. And we hope next year we'll be able to grow even further and expand our love and our talent and our knowledge of mankind, right? We want to do that because this is the end of the shtick for 2019.
Yeah.
You know that?
Holy.
It's show number 619.
Good.
So the next show we do will be 620, which will be in 2020.
Well, when are you getting all the Lord of Australia?
You're going to get one before me, mate.
Oh,
you're
a community,
excuse me,
man.
Usher, you are a national treasure. Oh. I must say, you are indeed, in my opinion, and I won't mention that you're my brother-in-law's brother-in-law, because that's tuchus mishpucha. That's the Yiddish word of the week, is tuchus mishpucha, which is what Usher and I are. But I've always loved Usher, irrespective of whether we're family or not. His work, and I'd love to direct you people to just Google Usher Bilu. We're going to end the show with a little bit of music from Usher Bilu, wishing everyone Happy New Year, Chag Sameach, Shana Tova. That's it. Well, it's a chag. We love the chag.
Ha ha.